Vario tent setup. Bag of gear already. And first look inside. It's gonna be warm in there, I think. So there we are, home sweet home. A few bits. It's the Van Gogh Aero 3 Compact. And my old Thermarest, so I thought I'd bring it along just in case this one's no good. And trying to get some air in this tent because it's rather warm. I haven't seen weather like this in North Wales for years. No cheers. Don't fancy going for a wander at the moment. Just going to enjoy the peace and quiet. And a little Trevant and big Trevant. And just off to the left, you can't see the glitters. Penetor went and the Canada. Dipping sun over Trevand, the glitters, and the sun's just dipping over Pennant or Wind, or some pronunciation like that. What a fantastic evening in Snowdonia. Adam and Eve on the top, just about, and a little Trevan and the campsite. So it's absolutely lovely evening. Seen streams quiet as that for many years. All the visits I've had up here. And we're raging torrents. Rays of sunshine, and you probably can't see, but the midges have come out in force. Yuck! But this is a bar with a view for sure, because not many bars have a view like that, but. Most of the bars I've been in though, got a lot less midges than this, and I've used bug spray with DEET in it or whatever it is. It's just like, it's just kind of spoils it really. Take it there, midges. I know you probably can see them, can you? They're flying around my head. Loads of them. I have to go and hide in the car or the tent. Well, the midges got the better of me, so I'm gonna turn in, just take it easy in the tent. The bag of goodies. What's that? It's really nice, though. A little bit of a light, a bit of a head torch there, and I can get the sleeping bag out. too bad. It's getting a bit warm in here, but the weather this morning is superb. It's just shit outside. Oh. And that's morning ablutions done. I'm there for breakfast. We've got the kettle ready with some tea, and then for afters we got instant oats with golden syrup and a couple of brioches. I'll get this in the bed and breakfast. And just wow. I'm so enthusiastic about this weather because it normally always rains when I'm here. I am the weather jinx. And the tourists, yeah, the tourists anyway, and go for a walk and go for a little walk. Just spotted a big pile of rocks over there. Let's see if it were a photograph. It's not exactly the best time to take a photograph at 10 past 10 on a sunny morning. Now than 1 or 2 o'clock, when the light's even harsher. But I might scope this out for a bit later on. Trying to have a spot on there. I think this is Lynn Ogwin. I'll put a comment in if I'm wrong. I'm sure. There's some colour in the sky, hopefully. We'll give it a go. So that's Lynn Ogwin, the Ogwin Valley done. I think it's time to move on, find another subject. The light's not brilliant now, it's way too high. But, there's not many people get days like this when they come up here. You can come up here and spend a whole week and it'd be clag going over the hills. Raining. It's very unpleasant sometimes, but apart from the midges, it's all very pleasant. Stopped by a lake, and it's a solo parking spot, so there shouldn't be anyone else around. And I found what looks like a lovely place for a picnic. Check that out. I think I'll sit down and have a bite to eat. Nice view in the lake. I know I should be here at sunset, but we're not camping around here. So I've got a polarizer on. These are format high-tech brads. Very nice. I've said that before though, until I got home and looked at it on the computer and it was blurred. There we go. Just stopped at another viewpoint. It's on the way up towards Lamberis Pass. Actually going to go around to Capelkirig again. That's a beautiful view of this valley. I think it's the Nant Gwynant. And yes, the sun is still shining. That's the whole of the Snowdon Horseshoe. And not exactly stopped for a photo stop, just stopped to chill out. And, around here there's a farm. I think down in that valley somewhere, and that's the farm that was the subject of a book written quite a few years ago now called I Bought a Mountain. And I think basically it was a townie that never been a farmer, certainly not a sheep farmer, went and bought this farm and basically the whole of the mountains that came with it. It's quite an interesting book. I've read it for many years. I believe he was quite a keen hill walker as well, and competed in the Welsh 3000s race.